What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about configuring a secure FTP server within Server 2022. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that I did was I want to show you guys that I am going to configure secure FTP within a Windows Server 2022. I'm actually running version 21H2. Okay, so first thing that we need to do on the desktop is we're going to right click on the start menu and I'm going to run Windows PowerShell as an admin because I'm going to do a lot of PowerShell, right? Now, the first command that we're going to run is the following, and we need to locate what we have so far within our system. So I did an open SSH with an asterisk, and once you hit enter, you're going to get this. You should get this. Now, you should automatically get something that it's already installed, and the next one is the server, which is what we are going to install right now. So we are going to run the following command, right? And once we hit enter, you're going to get this nice little blue tab that it is running and it's installing. But I received this, so I was like, what is going on? I know I typed it right. Now, to fix this issue, I'm going to show you guys how to fix it. Super simple. We're going to right click on the start menu and we are going to just click on run, and we are going to go inside the gpedit.msc. And within here, there's a particular group policy that we need to configure to allow us to use that particular command. So within computer configuration, we're going to locate administrative templates. Within administrative templates, we are going to go to inside systems. And within the systems folder, we are going to locate this particular GPO. Specify settings for optional components installation and component repair. So double click on that. And by default, it is disabled. So we are going to enable it. And we are going to pick download repair content and optional features directly from Windows Update instead of the Windows Server Update services. Once you pick that option, we are going to click on apply, okay it, and we're going to close your group policy. And go back inside your Windows PowerShell command, do a GP update force. Once everything is successful, run that command again. Once you hit enter, it's going to give you that blue tab again, but this time it is going to work. Awesome. Now, next thing that we need to do is we need to start the services of the SSHD. The next command that we need to do is set the services to automatically start up. Okay, so when you restart your machine, it automatically starts up. So we're going to run this particular command, hit enter. Boom. Now, the next one that we need to do, if you have your Windows firewall enabled within your server, we need to create a new firewall rule. I kind of recommend doing it within a GPO, but for this video, I did it locally and I did the following command, doing an inbound, and the protocol is a TCP, and we are allowing port 22, and hit enter. If everything goes well, you should get a nice little summary that everything was done and you should be good to go. Now, on the C drive, I created a root folder, and this is the name that I provided. And we need to also go inside the SSH configuration file to make some changes, because again, we just basically made a root folder, and we need to tell the SSH configuration file that this is where the root folder lives. So within this particular location right here, within programs data SSH, there is a SSH config file. So I recommend making a copy of this before you make any changes to the original. Make a copy of it. Now, you're going to open up the original. So within the SSHD config file, we want to go all the way to the bottom and locate the ch root directory, which is already set to none. And we need to change none to basically the root folder that we created within the C drive. Next thing that we need to do is remove the pound sign in front of the ch root directory and then save the file. So go back inside your Windows PowerShell and we need to restart the services. We need to restart the SSHD services. Once we do that, I went inside one of my machines and I loaded up my WinSCP. For the host name, I gave it the IP address. For the username, I actually gave it an Active Directory username. And the reason why is because my secure FTP server is part of Active Directory, so I'm able to do that. Now, if the server is not part of Active Directory, the way that you will provide credentials to people is that you will create local accounts onto that server. So once you provide that information, click on login. It's going to give you a warning. Click on yes, and it's going to load up. On your left-hand side, for me, this is my local machine. On the right-hand side, this is the server. So on the left-hand side, I went inside my desktop and I had a particular text file. So I dragged it and dropped it into the right-hand side and I got this nice little dialog box to upload. So I clicked on OK. Transfer was done. Awesome. I went inside my server, went inside my root folder, and there goes my text file. Awesome. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.